Hey folks, my name's Linus. I wanted to make a video about top 5 tips for how to get a kid into RPGs. I actually had more than 5 tips, but I'm gonna make another video. So this is the video that has to do with like zero game, first time, you know, the very first session, and things that might come up. And the next video is gonna be how to keep kids in RPGs once you've got them started. So these are some tips on the very first day, you know, maybe first game or two, how to get someone who's, you know, 5 to 10 years old into an RPG and have fun doing it. A little background, I have been doing this for about 7 years. I've been running games for kids for about 7 years. It's currently my full-time job. I built my own system called Adventure Survival that's focused towards elementary schoolers, and it's got a decreased emphasis on violence. A lot of the things that I learned, these tips and tricks, you know, I learned along the way. Hopefully this will make your life a little easier. And I've tried to watch some videos. I think this is some original information. I think this is stuff that I haven't seen in as many places, so I hope this is helpful. Okay, tip one, keep setup time short. I cannot emphasize this enough. When you are building a character sheet to get kids into things, you want it to take less than 10 minutes. And I'm ideally like 5. This is so, so important. Obviously, every kid is different. Some kids, you know, if you give them a book and they'll go through it and they'll just get sucked in. But by majority, I think that you're going to get more interest and more people with an open mind, more kids with an open mind, if you keep character sheet creation very short. Whether you're using a system meant for kids or if you're using a simplified system, like an adult system, but you've kind of peeled everything down, then you know, you want to keep setup time short, under 10 minutes. You can always add things back in as you go. You can always add in complicated things, but I think strip it down to the absolute, utter basics and get them into the game. Because I think that character sheet creation, it can be the biggest sort of hump to get over. I think even with adults, it can be challenging, you know, if you're getting into the game, but then it's like, all right, sit down and do some paperwork. And that's not a bad thing. Some people really, really love that part. Some people, I think, when you're first starting out, you know, it can be a challenge. It's like, how much work do I have to do before I get to have fun? And I think that kids make that analysis in their head as well. So keep character creation time short, as short as possible, get them into the game. And then once they have a feel for the game, once they're having fun, start adding things back in. Because I think they'll retain them better, and they'll also probably utilize them better if they already are into it. Tip number two, say yes as much as you can the very first game. So when kids are starting out, they're not only starting out like a new game, but they, you know, they may have never played an RPG before. And so it's very kind of unfamiliar territory. Anything that they want to do, they want to try to do, try to say yes. Don't break the game. Don't break the rules for them, but definitely consider maybe giving them a little bend. What's going to happen is kids are going to have fun, and they're going to associate the game with, like, getting it. It's just one of those things where if they're like, I want to do this, and you say, well, no, you can't because of this rule. They're like, okay, well, I want to do this. No, you can't because of this rule. Well, I want to do this. No, you can't because of this rule. At this point, they just, well, what can I do? And so reward creative thinking. Just try to say yes. Keep the session as open as possible. Have some plot, but, you know, let them explore, let them test things out, let them try things out. If you can't say yes, offer maybe like a slight amendment, like, well, because of this rule, if it's like a really important rule, you can't quite do it like this, but you could try this. And I know a lot of folks, if you are a DM, you know, if you've run games before, you're like, oh, well, Linus, you know, isn't that going to maybe open the door to, you know, in the future, you know, you let me do this time, so won't you let me do it this time? And I've just quite simply found that not to be the case. When people are starting out, I think a lot of it is they might not exactly understand the rules as well. And so going back and being like, well, you let me do this instead of this, you know, is less likely. And I think on average, kids are just less likely to rules lawyer. They're just, you know, once they get a little bit more experienced, if you set a precedent for a rule and then you don't enforce it, if you change it up, they definitely will be like, you know, Linus, you let me do it this one time, so not this time. But definitely, you know, just starting out, just say yes as much as you can. Embrace them experimenting in the world, them engaging in the world. And I've never really had a lot of problems with people going back to the first game being like, you let me do this, so why won't you let me do it this time? So, you know, don't break the rules, but definitely allow people to immerse themselves in this new world that they're exploring in, you know, whatever way they find. Tip number three, use a mentor character. Use a mentor NPC. This is very important. If you're not familiar with the concept of like a mentor NPC, it happens in adult games, and so you've got an NPC that is a little bit more, maybe a little bit more experienced, and so the party can go and maybe ask questions, and through that individual, you know, you as the DM can kind of maybe nudge them in a certain direction or offer some suggestions, offer some help without straight up doing it for them and still maintaining that immersion in the world. Instead of the DM being like, hey guys, you know, did you try that? You can have, you know, the mentor NPC be like, oh, well, I remember a time when, you know, that happened to me and I tried X, Y, and Z. So why is this extra important for kids? For kids, you should definitely using a mentor NPC. Because, you know, one, there's a good chance they might be entirely new to gaming. Not necessarily, but, you know, if they're young, there's a good chance that all of this is just brand new to them. And so you might do something where, like, okay, you walk through the door and, you know, a trap goes off and, like, acid falls on you. And they're like, but how was I supposed to even know that? Like, what's going on there? So having a mentor NPC can kind of keep things from feeling a little bit unfair. They can help kids learn some of the things that you know learn as you go, and another thing that mentor NPCs can kind of be nice for is they can kind of provide a certain sense of security. I think that when people are starting out, when there's this kind of NPC that seemed a little bit more friendly, a little bit more helpful, that seemed a little bit more connected with the DM, there's this kind of assumed security that, like, oh, well, like, this person's moving through the world with me. It's not a guarantee of safety, but if I, you know, if I have questions, if I have concerns, if this person's nearby, then they, you know, they might have the answer. And so what I like to do is I like to pick a character that maybe I've played as a PC in a game, and what I do is I maybe nerf them a little bit, because, you know, you don't want the mentor NPC to be doing everything for them. You know, you don't want them to just be like, oh, hey, you know, mentor NPC, can you give me this spell? So I like to take a PC, a character that I played that, you know, I've really enjoyed. I kind of nerf them a little bit, so that they're not doing everything for the player. And, you know, then also it's a character that I'm familiar with, that I enjoy playing. And so it's not just like, you know, Jim the Butcher walking along, like, hey, do this. And I think that kind of resonates when I'm playing, that it's like, oh, like, this is kind of like this slightly more friendly, slightly more fleshed out NPC. For bonus points, have the players rescue the NPC. I know you might not believe it, but having them in some way assist them, and then the NPC be like, oh, well, thank you, how can I help you? Then a lot of times that can be a good dynamic. They can really enjoy that. Tip number four, make sure the challenges are age appropriate. And I'm not talking about content here. So something that I've noticed is probably from like age up until around like 7 or 8, a lot of the focus for kids is learning skills to take care of themselves. You know, you gotta learn how to take care of yourself before you can kind of move out into the world. Beyond 7 or 8 or so, the shift starts to be a little bit more towards conquering challenges in the world. Like once you have the skills to take care of yourself, you know, that gets to be the age where maybe you might go start running maybe like errands for a parent. You know, you're going out in the world and doing things. So when you're picking challenges for kids in the game, make sure that they have the skills in their mind to do them, or else it can get to a place where they're like, I just don't even know what to do, and they run off and, you know, do something silly that isn't part of sort of the planned adventure. So I would say for kids under 8, you're looking more at ventures where you're kind of sending them on trips to go, you know, go get something, go retrieve something, go deliver something, take this message. And then over that age, you can get a little bit more into like the complex missions where it's like, go and solve this problem, go negotiate this deal, go, you know, solve these more complex issues. And something else to think about is there are times when, like, kids are going to enjoy adventures that might not necessarily be something you anticipate them enjoying. Like, anytime kids get to do adult stuff. Like, I remember as a kid, I just loved doing adult stuff. And so kids might be really, really happy, like, going and collecting some magical objects. And, like, I want to set up a store in, like, the town square. So be open to them getting to do just adventures based around like adult things. Like, and then also make sure that the challenges that you're giving them parallel the skills that they have acquired in their life so far. So they're not left sort of too overwhelmed. It was hard to settle on what the last tip would be, but tip number 5, get kids thinking about their backstories early. In my experience, sometimes kids don't always have all their backstory thought out, or even kind of creating a backstory might be a little bit more than what they were anticipating. But I think that backstories are really, really great. It gets the person immersed in the story. It gets you to a place where maybe you can take, once that backstory is a little bit more created, a little bit more fleshed out, you can put elements into the story, and that's going to draw people in even more. And the reason I included it in the getting kids into the game is because, you know, start it early, ask questions early, give kids lots of time to think about it. And I think talking to kids about that part of their character can be very engaging. You know, going and somebody saying, like, I want to be this and this and this in the game. Like, okay, let's go play. It's not bad, but, you know, then being like, well, hey, what about, you know, this? What about this part of your story? What about this part of your story? And not only does it get them thinking and gets you thinking, you know, it opens up different plot points possibly in the future, and it gets the kid thinking a little bit more about who this character is and thinking a little bit more dynamically and feeling like they are more invested in this story, at least if they are just starting out, if they're not super invested, the more they think about it, the more they will be. All right, so those are my tips for getting kids into RPGs. Like I said, I want to make another video that is, you know, 5 tips for keeping kids in an RPG that you started, because, you know, getting things going can be a little bit challenging, but, you know, once it's going, it can be going good. But there are some things that can pop up along the way that, you know, you want to keep things fresh, want to keep kids interested, keep them engaged. And so that's going to be that video. For the time being, I hope this has been helpful. I hope you have success getting the young people in your life into tabletop gaming. And I will see everyone soon. Game on.